Well known in the world of entertainment, David Muthengi, popularly known as Holy Dave, and his sister Joey Muthengi come from a family of scholars, and it is not surprising that they have immersed themselves into the world of academia.
Through the Muthengi Foundation, the learning experience of pupils across the country has been transformed. NTV's Sharon Baranga begins this week's United Nations Youth Week-inspired series of stories about young people impacting the society for good.
He wears many hats.
My name is David Muthengi, otherwise known as Holy Dave. People know me as a musician and TV host, but I guess people don't know this other side about me. I'm an investment analyst, trained with like 6 years' experience as an investment analyst. Nowadays, I'm lucky enough to be a part-time lecturer. And the work that I started with my sister Joy Muthengi, we co-founded the Muthengi Foundation, which is a non-profit registered charity organization in Kenya. And we raise support, we basically use our influence to raise support for education related needs in society.
And so in 2015, the Muthengi Foundation was registered. Improving the quality of life of needy learners was their main goal.
The government provides free primary education. You know, you can't go to school when you don't have uniforms. You can't go to school when you don't have electricity at home. You're going to have to wake up early to use the first rays of the sun to do your homework at school, which makes the evening for you unproductive time because you can't study.
Be the Light initiative is one of their projects that distributes solar lamps to needy children in rural areas of Kenya. This ensures learning does not stop and that children can still work on their homework.
We hope to reach 1,000 lamps because one retails at around 3,000 shillings.
David is also a board member of the Feature Uchi initiative, one that distributes school uniforms to needy pupils. As of now, the initiative has managed to raise 3,800 uniforms given to pupils from 38 schools in different counties. They have a target of getting to 10,000 uniforms.
Our founder is Billion Okoth Ojiwa. Billion started by taking 5 uniforms to his former primary school in Mathare. And from that, he made it a personal agenda to take 100 uniforms to each school. And that's when we connected in late 2015, early 2016.
And there are misconceptions that they've had to deal with.
Once you start an initiative or a foundation, people think that, you know, you're just trying to tap money from people in the West, or, you know, you're just trying to eat from it. Another thing is people in society think foundations are for rich people. People are asking, you have a foundation, okay. So that means you guys are wealthy and you're just giving towards the bank account. And that's not the case.
With this, I seek to inquire what exactly drives them.
I say that we're not in the business of charity. We're in the business of creating smiles. When you take uniforms to schools and you leave kids smiling because now they can lift up their hand in class and this area is not torn, so people are not laughing at them. That's my joy.
A parting shot to those who want to run a non-profit initiative.
Treat it like a business with the same amount of seriousness. Don't just say, oh, ni charity. It's charity. Yeah, we'll do it over the weekend.
Sharon Baranga, NTV.